It's a very basic question, but I feel like people that don't follow the region closely, like, why is this such a big deal, this designation by the U.S. that officially Jerusalem is the capital?
Good evening, Chris. It's a big deal for the world, basically. If this looks like a declaration of war on 1.6 million billion Muslims, basically. They consider Jerusalem, not only Jerusalem, they consider the holy site, the Aqsa Mosque, the Dome of the Rock, as the most important, the third basically most important holy site for all of them. But it's also a holy site for Christians, and not only Christians, Palestinians, for Christian internationally. That's why Jerusalem is a hot spot. And this act by President Trump looks like a diplomatic arson, as if this kind of vandalism strategy that has no sense when it comes to geopolitics. It has no consideration. The only sense that it makes might be for some evangelicals and Roy Moore, who's trying to basically he's trying to pander to his base. Mm-hmm. But my fear, and this is the message that we're seeing with his foreign policy that is very transactional, this is actually a payback for Sheldon Adelson, who gave him $35 billion. So what we're seeing is American foreign policy to bend towards the checkbooks of certain individuals who want to promote their kind of views of the world that are detached from reality. 20% of American Jews, only 20% consider this a good move. 80% of American Jews and the overwhelming majority of Israelis think that this kind of policy, unilateral decision, will basically wreck the Middle East and will transform the conflict from a political one to a religious one. And if you think Benghazi and what happened in the embassy there was a low point and a violent act, imagine this in with a bigger magnitude. And Jerusalem, once you touch that, this is the kind of reaction you will have. I want to remind our audience that in 2000, Prime Minister, he was not Prime Minister at that time, he was the leader of the opposition, Ariel Sharon, took hundreds of soldiers and walked around the mosque, triggering the second most violent intifada ever. Once you touch these religious sites, right, it basically are playing with fire.
So I should say, Sheldon Adelson, there's reporting indicating, obviously, he's a very, he donates a lot to Republicans, he donated to Donald Trump, super PACs. He was one of the people lobbying the president. There were others as well, Steve Bannon. And one of the things here that is strange about this particular issue is there's been a lot of doublespeak from Republicans and Democrats on Jerusalem forever. So you have all these symbolic votes. The Democrats will vote to move the Capitol and the embassy to Jerusalem, to declare the unified capital. You even have, here's Chuck Schumer, said that he told the Weekly Standard that he had advised Trump to declare Jerusalem as Israel's undivided capital. I guess the question is, what does it matter if the U.S. says this in terms of the what is left of the peace process?
Well, there's no peace process anymore because Trump destroyed it de facto. I think also the Israelis and the settlements. However, let's be clear. If Chuck Schumer and the Democrats and the Republicans agree that we are in a one-state reality, then the battleground, and basically what the battle for the Palestinians and the move, is to consider one country as a country with a binational state. Right. I am fine, honestly, as an Israeli citizen who is ethnically Palestinian, who looked at the conflict. If this is where we are moving, if the idea that Israel is an ethno-religious project of exclusion and purity, which is what Bannon would like to have in America, what Charlottesville, basically, we saw the kind of sympathy towards these white supremacists. If that's the kind of project for Israel, then we need to declare that this is not a democracy anymore. Basically, we control the lives of millions of Palestinians. But if they want to keep the whole country, and it seems this is where we're heading, then you have to grant full and equal rights
Palestinians. So this is
where we're heading.
The standard, and this is, I think, why this is impossible. This is important just to highlight this, right? So what you're saying is that the standard U.S. policy is that we support two states for two different peoples, and a big part of that is that Jerusalem is a final status issue. We're going to run a peace process. Eventually, both peoples will have their own independent states living in peace, and we will figure out Jerusalem. What I hear from you saying is that the declaration of Jerusalem is being read by Palestinians as a declaration that essentially the U.S. has given up on that project, and now we have entered a new era, and people should reconcile with that. Rula Jibril, thank you for joining me. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
All right, still to come, another Democrat accused